A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 25th November, on the front page you have floor test plea. Supreme Court wants governor's order, Fadnavis letter. So the Supreme Court on Sunday put on hold a plea for ordering a floor test in the Maharashtra Assembly till it examined records that might shed light on what led Governor Bhagat Singh Devendra Fadnavis to Bhagat Singh Koshyari to invite BJP leader Devendra Fadnavis to form the government. So, you know, he was sworn in as Chief Minister on November 23. So, the three-judge bench led by Justice N.V. Ramanna has requested Solicitor General Tushar Mehta in his capacity as Centre's law officer to place on record before the court the letter of Mr. Fadnavis to the governor staking claim to form the government, and also it wants the governor's order. Then here you have, because we knew BJP didn't have majority to form the government, so and when BJP and the other parties like NCP, Shiv Sena and Congress were planning to form a government through coalition, then how did BJP get the majority? How was he sworn in? Then below you have NSO survey debunks Swachh Bharat ODF claims. So the latest National Statistical Office survey on sanitation debunked the claims of an open defecation free India made by the center's flagship Swachh Bharat scheme. So it did record great progress in toilet access and use of rural areas, but the results released showed that about 71% of rural households had access to toilets at a time when center has claimed 95% had access. So on October 2019, Prime Minister Narendra Modi had declared that the whole country was open defecation free with complete access to toilets. So that's not right. On page 5 you have Chhattisgarh panchayats to have disabled quota. So the Chhattisgarh cabinet has approved nomination of at least one differently abled member to each panchayat if not elected. So it's the only state to have such members in all panchayats now, as it has announced now. So differently abled people, it says, comprise 6% of the population of Chhattisgarh. Also, another decision being taken is the education eligibility criteria for elections have been dropped. So these are the two decisions taken. So it was mandatory for contestants for the position of panch to be at least a class 5 pass, and above that class 8 pass. So in the 3-tier panchayat raj system, only being literate would be enough to contest elections now. So no class 5 and class 8 pass criteria anymore, only the person should be literate. On page 8 you have 800 houses flooded as lake breaches in Bengaluru. So this is third such incident in 2 months which have taken place, and around 800 houses were inundated, and this is regarding Hulemavu Lake of Banerghatta Road in Bengaluru. So over 1,000 people have been affected because of this lake breach. Then below you have Railway Institute opens in Hyderabad. So Indian Railways has given a lot of importance to human resource development and training of its personnel, and towards this end it wants to integrate functioning of all the top central training institutes with the Railway University at Vadodara for developing world class training. So Railway Board Chairman has stated so, and the needed training institute and proper infrastructure in Rail Vikas Nigam Limited has shown the way in building a world-class infrastructure at Indian Railway Institute of Financial Management at Hyderabad. So that has been opened. On page 9 you have Centre nudging MP UP on Cane Betwa. So this is actually a river interlinking project. It's an 18,000 crore project which has been mired in controversy. So it has been in news quite often earlier too. So government is once again, the central government is pushing Uttar Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh to make progress on Ken Betwa river interlinking project. So this was a question raised in Rajya Sabha too. So it's transferring surplus water from Ken River in Madhya Pradesh to Betwa in Uttar Pradesh, and it will irrigate around 3.64 lakh hectares in Bundelkhand region of both states. So this has been pushed for again. So the 2005 agreement between the two states on how water would be shared, it is said, is no longer valid. So Madhya Pradesh says these assumptions are no longer valid, and the only way to meet the increased water requirements would be to include local management projects. That is the Kotha Barrage, Lower Aur, and Bina complex that were envisaged in the second phase of the project should be included in the first phase. So that's the demand of Madhya Pradesh, because Madhya Pradesh river water would be transferred. So it has put forth its demand. Below you have detained Bangladeshi immigrants brought to Kolkata. So Prime Minister of Bangladesh Sheikh Hasina was on a visit to India, and she returned to her country, and later we found that there is this group of around 59 Bangladeshi persons who have come to the country, and they are all stateless and persona non grata. So these are the two phrases used by the police to describe them. They are Bangladeshi citizens. So the group has been escorted from Bengaluru to Howrah railway station to a journey of about 36 hours. So they did not deny that they are from Bangladesh, and they had been living in India for many years in Bengaluru, working as rag pickers. So now the Karnataka police is in a quandary with the group, which is the largest in recent years to be brought to West Bengal from South India. So the Bangladesh government should accept them. They should have papers to prove that they are Bangladeshi residents so that they can be sent back. So this is the dilemma before the police here now. And below you have 85 stolen idols to be brought back to India next March. So close to 85 idols of the 2,622 idols seized from art smuggler Subhash Kapoor with a combined value of US$107 million during the 2012 raid. So in 2012 raid, these were the idols seized. So out of these, 85 will be brought back to India in March 2020. This is the first phase. So this is what art enthusiast and founder of India Pride that tracked Indian antiques as such has announced. So but then the question is that idols would be brought back, but who would claim ownership of the idols, as there was no clarity about the temples from where the idols were stolen. So you should know about Subhash Kapoor. He has been prominently in news. He has been arrested for this international racket of stealing idols from Indian temples, having fake documents prepared and selling them in overseas markets. So he has been arrested, and these idols you can see have been seized, out of which 85 are proposed to be returned to India. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Midnight Coup. So this is regarding what has happened in Maharashtra now. So Fadnavis, Devendra Fadnavis, has been sworn in as Chief Minister in Maharashtra by the governor. So this editorial says what we saw on the front page too, that Fadnavis should be asked to seek a confidence vote immediately. And below you have Star Alliance. So this is regarding Southern India in Kollywood. You can see it is said the film world had room for both, but Kamal and Rajni find the space crammed in politics. So Kamal Hassan and Rajnikant are cinematic heroes, and now they have ventured into politics in Tamil Nadu. So it's regarding that. The lead article is Tiruvalluvar is unstriped, uncolored, unaging. So this is regarding Tiruvalluvar, famous Tamil poet and writer. He has actually been depicted by BJP state unit of Tamil Nadu in saffron robes. So now this lead article says that Tiruvalluvar is beyond physical construct to be appropriated. The saffron that has drifted to his image will not touch him. So he is not appropriated to any religion. It's Tamil scholar as such. So he cannot be shown to be belonging to one particular religion. So that's what this article emphasizes on. He's above religion. And this is the broken promise of decent and fair wages. So this talks about the draft rules to the Wages Act a law expected to provide economic and social justice. Now this article says the rules framed will only exploit workers further. So, you know, it says starvation wages are what it calls for. So you can see it was believed that informal workers account for 93% of total working population and contribute over 60% of India's GDP. So when the wage act actually called for living wages for all, it was expected that it would bring justice to all the workers. But the rules which have been formulated are actually against those provisions. So they talk about floor wages. Here you can see. So this article calls these are not floor wages, rather they are starvation wages. So the proposed, you can see. So you can see the draft rules proposed were received with much hope, but you can see the landmark jurisprudence in the Supreme Court in the Draptakos case, which advocated concept and right of a living wage, is not upheld in the draft rules. So a concept of floor wages has been proposed in the draft rule, which currently guarantees just ₹178 per day and will continue to exist as such. So this government is saying that in ₹178 per day, person should get food, clothing, shelter and a decent living. So it says average family expenditure in rural areas is ₹83 per day and in urban areas is ₹134. So based on this, it is providing this as the floor rate. And it is not just this, another provision which is there, which is of huge concern in the law, is its provision of an arbitrary deduction of wages up to 50% of monthly wages based on performance, damage or loss and advances. So where employees they have higher social status and continue to exploit workers, they have been given this leeway too, that they can deduct wages too, based on performance. So then that is in their hands. Then what's the question of minimum wage? Then on op-ed page you have Vedantic attachment and Islamic idolatry. So this talks about the Babri Masjid dispute and how the dichotomy between religious theory and practice is seen. In Mecca, it is said a large number of historic sites, including mosques and even sites associated with Prophet Muhammad's life, are being broken by the guardians of the Kaaba. So this is being done to prevent these sites from becoming shrines, for that would amount to idolatry. So this talks about how Islam talks forbids idolatry. And any structure site which you can see are mosques associated with Prophet Muhammad, they are broken so that they are not becoming place for pilgrims to as such, where they revere the structure. So that's the idea. So this is talking about how it's actually giving an argument about how the Muslims should accept another site for the mosque and allow the temple to be constructed at Babri Masjid site. And this is an ill-advised proposal. So this is a proposal to merge Assam Rifles and Indo-Tibetan Border Police. So this article says that this will impinge on national security and affect the morale of the force. On page 12, you have Saab seeks clarity on strategic partnership. So Swedish defense minister, defense major Saab, the defense organization which has fielded Gripen for Indian Air Force tender for 114 fighter jets, is looking for clarity on some provisions of the strategic partnership route of the defense procurement procedure. So what is this strategic partnership is it wants to know clearly on. So the expression of interest from Indian Air Force also has not yet come. So these are same fighter jets for which the issue arose between Rafael, the Dassault company, and Indian government because of strategic partnership and Make in India. So now again a new tender would be floated for fighter jets, and that's what an expression of interest would come. But before that, only Saab, we have seen the Swedish defense company has been very keen since the beginning for these fighter jets. So it wants more clarity on the strategic partnership aspect. Recently, also you should know that SAAB pulled out of the Navy's tender for 6 advanced conventional submarines under Project 75I. So Project 75 submarines, that project went to French company. Scorpion submarines have been procured. And now next Project 75I for more conventional submarines have been floated, in which SAAB pulled out. So the reason it gave was lack of clarity on strategic partnership route and tough provisions. So now even here it is questioning and is seeking more detail on strategic partnership. And this is Arunachal seeks new officer cadre. So for states, you know, central government officers when they appointed, the cadre for northeastern states of Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram, and even Goa, and for all union territories, there's this AGMUT cadre. So Arunachal Pradesh is now saying that it wants a separate cadre of bureaucrats because of its cultural and topographic diversity, not this joint cadre. So that's the demand here. Below you have UP Primary Health Center's ailing, center says in Lok Sabha. So it has shown that state has the worst patient doctor ratio and most number of centers are without electricity, water supply and good roads. So this is the information regarding UP's primary health centers put forth in Lok Sabha. So Uttar Pradesh, Chhattisgarh and Odisha have significant shortfall of doctors in public health centers. And this is Manipur, Jammu and Kashmir top UAPA cases, that is Unlawful Activities Prevention Act cases. So more than 35% of the cases registered under stringent UAPA were recorded in Manipur. And this is the data which has come forth from National Crime Records Bureau. So second comes Jammu and Kashmir. So this is on page 13 you have Center extends ban on Bodo insurgent group NDFB. So Center has extended ban on Assam-based Bodo insurgent group National Democratic Front of Bodoland for 5 more years now. And this is Kovind gives assent to Maharashtra bill to protect media persons. So this is a legislation passed by Maharashtra Assembly in 2017 that makes violent attacks on media persons a non-bailable offense. So this act has been given assent by the president. It was reserved by the governor for the president. So Maharashtra is the first state to pass such a legislation. On international page, you have record turnout in Hong Kong elections. So over 71% of voters cast their votes in the elections, which were seen as a test of public support for anti-government protests. So there has been a record turnout. These were elections which are held to vote for district councils. Then here you have Pakistan needs to rebrand itself away from terror. So this is what UK panel says. It says it is like a shark, poses existential threat to its neighbors. So panel of academics and South Asian experts from around the world explore the prospect of a Pakistan that rebrands itself away from an ideology of jihad and terrorism, with Pakistan diaspora playing some role in such a move. So this is reimagining Pakistan as such. So a study which has been put forth. Then on the business page on Mondays, you have money-wise coverage, so that is not important. And the last page has sports-related news. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, aashar.com. Thank you.